Me llamo Raquel, my name is Raquel, and bienvenidos a San Bruno Library presenta Once Upon a Time. Welcome to San Bruno Library presents Once Upon a Time. Y hoy voy a leer cuentos en español y en inglés. Today, I'll be reading to you stories in English and in Spanish. So vamos a empezar. We will start with a song, un canción que se llama Hola Amigos, Hello My Friends. And you're going to clap with me. Van a aplaudir así. ¿Listos? Hola amigos, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? Muy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted? ¿Y usted? Muy bien, good. ¿Otra vez? We're going to do it again. You're going to repeat after me. Van a repetir después de mí. ¿Listos? ¿Ready? Okay. Hola amigos, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? Muy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted? ¿Y usted? ¡Excelente! ¡Excellent! Y ahora en inglés. Now in English. Hello, my friends, how are you? How are you? Very well, I thank you, how about you? How about you? Again, hello, my friends, how are you? How are you? Very well, I thank you, how about you? How about you? Muy bien, good job. Okay, vamos a empezar con el primer cuento. We're going to start with the first story. El título es Los pingüinos adoran los colores por Sara Aspinal. We're going to start with the first story, Penguins Love Colors by Sara Aspinal. El arco iris, the rainbow. Había una vez 6 pingüinitos que adoraban los colores.
Once there were 6 little penguins. 6 little penguins who loved colors.
Lo cual resultaba gracioso porque donde ellos vivían,
which was kind of funny because where they lived,
todo era tan blanco como la nieve.
Everything was snowy white.
Se llamaban tulipán, lirio atrigado, diente de león, violeta, jacinto, y broccoli.
Their names were tulip, tiger lily, dandelion, violet, bluebell, and broccoli.
¿Puedes adivinar por qué?
Can you guess why?
Porque su mamá también adoraba los colores. Y cada pingüino se llamaba como una flor de color brillante.
Because Mama Penguin loved colors, too. And each penguin was named after a brightly colored flower.
Un día, los pingüinitos querían darle una sorpresa a su mamá.
One day the penguins wanted to make a surprise for her.
¿Qué podían hacer?
What could they do?
Ya sé, dijo Tulipán. Usemos nuestras pinturas y hagamos el cuadro más colorido que podamos.
I know, said Tulip. Let's use our paints and make the most colorful picture we can.
¿Crees que estos pingüinitos adoraban pintar sobre la nieve y el hielo perfectamente blancos? Do you think these little penguins love to paint on perfect white ice and snow?
¿Qué piensan? What do you think?
Por supuesto que sí. They certainly did. Los pingüinitos se pusieron a trabajar.
The penguins got to work.
Cada uno usó su color preferido.
All of them used their favorite color.
Rojo. Red. Anaranjado. Orange. Oh, ¿qué color es este? Do you know this color? En español es amarillo. In English, yellow. Oh, morado. Purple. Azul.
Blue.
Y verde.
And green.
¿Crees que hicieron un desastre?
Do you think they made a mess?
¿Qué piensan?
What do you think?
Sí. Yes, of course. Estaban cubiertos de pintura de arriba y abajo.
From top to bottom, they were covered with paint.
¡Allí viene mamá! Susurró Lirio Atrigado. Here comes mama, whispered Tiger Lily. ¿Le gustará su sorpresa? Would she like her surprise? ¡Ay, qué lindo! Exclamó mamá. ¡Wow, beautiful! Cried mamá with delight. Un arco iris maravilloso y tantas flores bonitas. ¡Qué pingüinitos tan inteligentes!
A wonderful rainbow and so many beautiful flowers. What clever little penguins you are!
¿Sabía mamá quién había pintado cada flor?
Did Mama Penguin know who painted each color?
Por supuesto que sí.
Of course she did.
¿Y tú lo sabes?
Do you know?
Rojo, red, pintada por tulipán,
painted by tulip.
Anaranjado, orange, pintado por lirio atrigado,
painted by tiger lily.
Amarillo,
yellow,
pintado por diente de león,
painted by dandelion.
Morado, purple, pintado por violeta,
painted by violet.
Azul,
blue,
pintado por Jacinto,
painted by Bluebell.
Verde,
green,
pintado por Broccoli,
painted by Broccoli.
Los pingüinitos estaban tan contentos que saltaron y dieron brincos arriba y abajo.
These little penguins were so happy they jumped up and flipped all the way upside down.
Adoro mi sorpresa, dijo mamá. I love my surprise, said mamá. Adoro las flores y los colores, pero no tanto como adoro a mis 6 pingüinitos.
I love flowers and I love colors, but not as much as I love my 6 little penguins.
6 pingüinitos que necesitan un baño.
6 little penguins who need a bath.
Los pingüinitos se restregaron dentro de la bañera hasta estar limpios.
Did these penguins scrub and scrub inside the tub until they were clean again?
I think so.
Sí, yes.
Y cuando terminaron, estaban agotados.
And when they were finished, the 6 little penguins were worn out.
Así que acurrucaron para una siesta seguros y felices, en el tibio y amoroso regazo de su mamá. So they cuddled up for a nap, safe and happy, in Mama's warm, loving lap. Qué bonito. How nice. Fin. The end. And that's 6 pingüinitos. And hopefully, ojalá, que aprendieron sus colores en español. And, y en inglés. And hopefully you learned some colors in Spanish and in English. Now we're going to sing a song called Los Pollitos, Baby Chicks. ¿Y qué dicen los pollitos? Dicen piu piu. And you're going to follow along with me, okay? Van a seguir mis movimientos. You're going to follow my movements, okay? Dicen piu piu los pollitos. Los pollitos dicen piu piu piu. Cuando tienen hambre, cuando tienen frío, la gallina busca el maíz, el trigo, les da la comida, les presta el abrigo, bajo sus dos alas, acurrucaditos, hasta el otro día, duermen los pollitos. ¡Muy bien! In English, now in English. Baby chicks are singing, pío, pío, pío. Mama, we are hungry. Mama, we are cold. Mama looks for wheat. Mama looks for corn. Mama feeds them dinner. Mama keeps them warm. Under Mama's wing, sleeping in the hay, baby chicks all cuddle until the next day. Oh, what a nice song. Qué bonito canción, ¿verdad? Okay, no se duermen, don't sleep, okay? No es hora de siesta, it's not time for nap. Vamos a descansar y regresar para más cuentos y más canciones. You're gonna come back, you're gonna take a break for more songs and rhymes and stories. Okay, see you in a few. Adios, nos vemos. Welcome back. Bienvenidos para más cuentos y canciones, for more songs and more stories. Me llamo Raquel. My name is Raquel. Y bienvenidos a Once Upon a Time. San Bruno Library presents Once Upon a Time, Hora de Cuentos, con la Biblioteca de San Bruno. Y vamos a leer y cantar. So vamos a cantar otra canción que se llama Tortillitas. We're going to sing another song titled Tortitas because tengo hambre. Y vamos a aplastar. We're going to smash our tortillas flat like this. And we're going to make our tortillas for mamá and papá. Vamos a hacer tortitas para mamá y papá. Okay? Tortillitas para mamá, tortillitas para papá. Las calentitas para mamá, las quemaditas para papá. Little tortillas for mama, little tortillas for papa, the warm ones for mama, the crispy ones for papa. Muy bien. Vamos a cantar otra vez. We're going to sing it one more time. Pero esta vez vamos a dar las calientitas for papa and las quemaditas para mamá. Porque a mí me gustan las tortitas quemaditas. Okay? So we're going to sing it again, but this time we're going to give the warm ones to papá and the crispy ones for mamá, because I love the crispy tortillas, okay? All right. Tortillitas para mamá, tortillitas para papá, las calientitas para papá, las quemaditas para mamá. Little tortillas for mama, little tortillas for papa, the warm ones for papa, the crispy ones for mama. Qué rico, tortillas. Ok, vamos a leer otro cuento. Y este cuento, el título es Rubia and the Three Osos, por Susan Middleton Elia. This book is titled Rubia and the Three Osos by Susan Middleton Elia. Este libro está en inglés con palabras en español. So this book is in English with Spanish words sprinkled inside of it. Okay? Y estos libros me gustan mucho. Por Susan Middleton Elia. By Susan Middleton Elia. There once were three osos who lived by themselves. They stored their three platos for soup on the shelves. But one night at supper, la sopa prepared, the soup platos ladled and chairs derriered. Mama said, "Let's go for a walk before dinner. It's part of my Southwoods plan, so I'll be thinner." Papa rolled his eyes, but he said he still nodded, "Sí." Bebe pushed his cubby cart after them. Whee! They headed away, but the door wasn't locked. Then who should come over so daintily frocked? Oh, little Miss Rubia, curls made of oro. A tiny casita for me? La adoro. So cute. Ay, qué lindo. She opened la puerta and saw the fine food. Sopa, she said. I am so in the mood. The big bowl was steaming. Caliente, too hot. And the middle one, frío. What else have they got? Eso, she spotted the tiniest bowl. Perfecto, she blurted, and then drank it whole. She noticed three sillas where she could sit down. The big one, too dura. It made the girl frown. The middle one, suave. But it wouldn't do. The tiny one, great. Until she broke it in two. Snap. The soup made her sleepy. And she headed upstairs and found las tres camas for all of the bears. La grande was hard, the middle one soft, but there was a little bed up in the loft. The small one was buena, so that's where she lay. Then here came Papa, Mama, and Bebe. They opened the door and noticed la mesa, where one bowl sat empty. Bebe's sad sorpresa. Mi sopa, he yelled. He started to cry. They didn't just eat it, they licked the bowl dry. Oh, Mama saw his silla. Oh, what have they done? Grrr, Papa growled in anger. The perp better run. Just then, little Rubia sat up in bed. This home isn't mine. It's for those guys instead. She dashed for the window and jumped to a tree. Soon she was chased by the angry bears three. They ran right behind her, but she had good speed. The girl got away. Then she did a good deed. ¿Qué está haciendo? What is she doing?
Is she making soup? ¿Está haciendo sopa? ¿En su olla? In her bowl, in her pot?
She came back with sopa, along with some glue.
Lo siento,
she said, especially to you. She served Bebe sopa and helped patch his silla, then gave him a ride in his cub carretilla.
Stay, said Mama, as she kneaded some masa.
Sí, said Papa, our house is tu casa.
Rubia felt love from the family also, and having their friendship was great. Fabuloso. ¿Qué están cantando?
Fin. The end. Wonder what they were singing.
Ooh, we should sing ourselves.
Bueno.
Okay, ¿qué vamos a cantar? Oh, ya sé. Vamos a cantar o contar hasta 10.
A ver, we're gonna sing and count to 10. Sound good? Vamos a practicar. Let's practice counting our numbers in español. Okay, we're gonna count our numbers in Spanish. Okay. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez.
Muy bien.
Now in English, in inglés. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Yes, very good. Okay, dos manitas. Can you show me your two hands?
Muy bien.
Dos manitas, diez deditos. Dos manitas, diez deditos. Dos manitas, diez deditos. Cuéntalos conmigo. Uno, dos, tres deditos. Cuatro, cinco, seis deditos. Siete, ocho, nueve deditos. Y uno más son diez.
Good job. Buen trabajo. Okay. In English.
Okay. Two little hands, ten little fingers. Two little hands, ten little fingers. Two little hands, ten little fingers, count them all with me. One, two, three little fingers, four, five, six little fingers, seven, eight, nine little fingers, and one more makes ten.
Oh, now you know your numbers. Ya saben sus números en español y en inglés. All right. Muy bien.
Okay. Vamos a contar otro cuento. Y son... Se llama este libro Cerditos, Piggies, Los Deditos, Cerditos, Little Piggies, por Audrey Wood, by Audrey Wood. Piggies, Cerditos. Oh, tengo dos cerditos. I've got two fat little piggies. Dos cerditos muy listos. Two smart little piggies. Oh, dos cerditos largos. Two long little piggies. Dos cerditos simpáticos. Two silly little piggies. Y dos cerditos chiquitines. And two little wee little piggies. A veces son cerditos acalorados. Sometimes they are hot little piggies. Y a veces son cerditos helados. And sometimes they're cool little piggies.
Brr.
A veces son cerditos limpios. Sometimes they're clean little piggies.
Muy bien, qué bueno.
Y a veces son cerditos muy sucios.
And sometimes they are dirty little piggies. A veces son cerditos buenos. Sometimes they are good little piggies. Bueno. Pero, no a la hora de irse a dormir, but not at bedtime. Entonces saltan sobre mi barriguita. That's when they skip down my tummy. Y bailan sobre los dedos de los pies. And then they dance on my toes. Y luego corren a esconderse. Then they run away and hide. Así que, so, los pongo a todos juntos en una fila. I put them together all in a row. Y se dan dos besos gordos for two fat kisses. Dos besos listos, two smart kisses. Dos besos largos, two long kisses. Y dos besos simpáticos, two silly kisses. Y dos besos chiquitines de buenas noches. And two wee kisses, good night. Buenas noches, good night. Y esos son los cerditos, piggies. Okay. Well, vamos a cantar una canción otra vez. We're going to sing it, the next song one more time that I sang earlier, Los Pollitos, okay? Los pollitos dicen pío, pío, pío cuando tienen hambre, cuando tienen frío. La gallina busca el maíz, el trigo, les da la comida, les presta el abrigo. Bajo sus dos alas, acurrucaditos, hasta el otro día, duermen los pollitos. Okay, in English. Baby chicks are singing, pío, pío, pío. Mama, we are hungry, mama, we are cold. Mama looks for wheat, mama looks for corn. Mama feeds them dinner, mama keeps them warm. Under mama's wing, sleeping in the hay, baby chicks all cuddle until the next day. Muchas gracias. Thank you so much for joining me today at story time. Gracias por estar conmigo. Y nos vemos. Adiós. See you later.
So
bye.
Sit me down and let the spell begin. I'll find myself in story time again.